Hi guys, how are you? I hope all of you are wonderful. And are you preparing? Can you people listen to me first? Tell me, am I audible to all of you? Okay, Avinash, I'm also good. Good evening to you as well. Vikas, welcome. Sakshi, how are you? I hope you're good. Mohan Kaul, I hope you're also good. And I hope all of you are wonderful. Okay, Diksha, good evening. Yes, Rishi, I've heard about this tentative date of exam. That is from 15th to 20th of October. I think this is a good news. Instead of worrying, you should be like happy that exam is going to get conduct. And you should prepare hard. You have at least a month left. So don't worry about that. It's rather good. You people are preparing and the exam date has come. So it's wonderful. Prepare from today, make your schedule and work hard. Nothing to worry, okay? Almost, 60 to 70% of your syllabus is over. We are left with what? We are left with, a bit of statistics and a bit of science. Science, I'm sure that you'll be doing by yourself. That's not a problem. And the most challenging part of yours, accountancy, that is almost done, I think. But then also, I'll talk to Jatin sir and other tutors also that let's push hard and finish our syllabus so that at least you get 10 to 15 days to revise. Anayat, yes, Anayat, it's not about easy. It's about that you should practice it at home every day, daily. Give half an hour or 15 minutes or 20 minutes of, your schedule on this thing and practice it and I'm sure you'll be done with that. Okay. So let me type a message in the WhatsApp group so that if others are there and they should also join. And meanwhile, you people can tell me, how's your preparation going on? Okay, Avinash has said 50-50. Avinash, is it a cricket match? 50-50, 20-20? It's always good or bad. And it's always good, okay? Good, Rishi. Okay, good. And why is that only Mohan Kaul is saying that I miss many classes and now depend on offline classes? Yes, if you have missed that, then you have to depend on offline classes, Mohan. But don't worry. I'm sure you're a hardworking student. You will be through. Okay. Anayat, accountancy ki tension hai. You don't need to worry about that. Anayat, accountancy, how much marks it carry? 30 marks only. So think, 30 marks only. Na? So you don't need to worry much about that. Plan a strategy. Skip the topics that you think that are difficult. No problem. Because ultimately, nobody is going to see that how much you prepared. Everybody is going to see how much what you have done in the exam sheet. So skip. If you feel that you don't have time and if you feel that something is difficult for you and it is not worth giving the effort, focus upon, you have 70 other marks also. And if you can take 20 out of it, that's wonderful. Guys, it's more about strategy than hard work to crack an exam. Okay. I'm telling you, I'm not telling you to not work hard, but I'm just telling you to, choose your decisions wisely and make a strategy. Okay. I think everybody has joined. Advik is texting me. Mohan Kaul is asking me what will be the cut as per your experience. Mohan, I cannot exactly tell you what, Salim, good evening. I cannot exactly tell you what the cutout is going to be, but one thing I can tell you as per my experience that is going to be high. So do not think that it is not going to be high. Because reason being, the lot of people who are preparing for this particular exam, and given the number of vacancies, okay, that are also pretty high, and number of people have applied for it, so more than 3 lakh something, I think, which I heard about. So it is going to be high. Salim is asking, sir, our syllabus is incomplete. What to do, Salim? We have one full month. Don't worry, syllabus is going to be complete. So don't worry. Don't have to worry. But just do not only depend upon syllabus. Work hard. I told you that what you have to do is you have to go and do MCQs. You have to do other things also, like whatever I told you in previous lectures of mine about the strategy. And all those things, if you comply, I think you'll be easily through exam. And we have a month with us. I'm sure we'll be through our syllabus. And I'll talk to other tutors also. I told the students earlier that we'll push syllabus. And we'll make sure that you have at least 15 days to revise. Okay. But meanwhile, what you people have to do, you have to study every day. So that it's not that, syllabus gets complete, but you're left with 15 days, but you do not revise. So you have to revise simultaneously along with what is taught. Okay. And is the question today regarding, I know tentative calendar has come. So tension has cropped into your mind that what to do, what not to do. Any other question you people want to ask me? Mohan call, it was my luck that I joined PW department as junior assistant, but still want to be account assistant. Wonderful, Mohan. Whatever you want to do in your life, that's good. And you have to work hard. Okay, that wasn't the question. Any other question if you people want me to tell you about the strategy? So is there any new student today? I am not expecting a new student in the middle of the session. But just tell timetable. Okay, Avinash, I got you what you wanted to ask me. I'll tell you, if you dedicate this 1 month, you'll be through this. Okay? You'll be through this exam. And how you have to prepare is, what people can do is, first of all, this something that I'm telling you to right now is you should have done it very earlier. You need to take a printout of your syllabus first. That is very important, guys. Take a hard copy of printout and pin that printout in front of wherever you people study. Okay, in the front of the wall, opposite wall, printout. Okay, take that, pin that there. So that you should get to know, okay, these are the sections that I have to complete. And every, look at one particular section, start solving MCQs, try to complete your syllabus, okay? And tick every topic that you have done and make daily targets, small targets, but daily targets. Like, for example, you're studying economics and there are 10 different chapters, divide the 10 different chapters in 5 days, 2 topics a day, okay? And then, mark early in the morning when you wake up that these 2 topics I have to do today. And before, going to the bed, you have to make sure that you complete those topics. Rishi, don't worry. Mathematics and statistics will complete. We have 1 month, guys. It's not been, how much time it's been we started? Around 25 days. But I would say 20 days just because, because the real pace has been from, around 20 days. So we have more than 30 days. We have around 30 days left. So don't you think that we'll be able to complete? For sure. Within 15 days, we'll be able to complete, guys. And we'll make sure that you are left with 15 days to prepare and revise. Yes. Advik is texting me and saying that, sir, I'm not able to connect. Advik, I'm sure Advik won't be able to hear because he's not here. I have to text him back. Try to join once again. ओके अपलोड पेंडिंग वीडियोस एंड प्रायोरिटी मोहन कॉल ऑल द वीडियोस दे आर अपलोडेड डोंट वरी देर आई डोंट थिंक देर इज एनी बैकलॉग और समथिंग लाइक दैट ओके एंड इवन इफ इट इज आई विल टॉक टू सुविज्ञ इट विल बी डन डोंट वरी डोंट पैनिक ओके दिस इज द टाइम वेयर यू हैव टू यू नो होल्ड योर नर्व्स वर्क हार्ड प्रिपेयर हार्ड मेक स्ट्रेटेजी एंड अल्टीमेटली क्रैक एग्जाम I think this you people should be happy because you people have a clear time frame in front of you that okay there's a month for you you know in front of you and you people have to crack this exam within this month. Otherwise, when there is no timeline, you people you know anybody would like would not be preparing. Yeah, day and night study. Mohan Kaul is writing. Yes, exactly. Accountancy class Anayat and. Don't worry, it will be done. I'm telling you. Don't worry about accountancy. I'm not, you know, understanding one simple thing. Accountancy carries only 30 marks, guys. Nobody is going to ask you that whether you know accountancy or not. Ultimately, it is going to be your exam sheet. Okay. So do not make this mistake because you people are here. I must tell you one thing. Most of the people would be making this mistake that they would be focusing more than required on accountancy. You people have to focus on each and every aspect. Your mark score of 100, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 is not going to tell you that, okay, he scored 30 out of 30 in accountancy and none in others. That is not going to be. You're not going for assistant professor's jobs and you're not applying for commerce, okay? You are applying for accountancy, this account assistant, and this is a syllabus which carries different sections, and you have to compete in every section. So devote proper time to each and every section. Instead of completing one whole section, try to complete all the sections. Even if you can, complete a bit, because think from the perspective of a person who is going to set exam. He's going to, if there is 10 marks allocated to economics, there would be 10 marks for it in the exam and you have to work for it. It is not that you're going to do 30 for accountancy and 60 for GK. No. Salim, don't worry. There must be a lot. I'll tell you, you'll be amazed by listening to this thing that the people who are going to crack this exam, most of them, they are not going to be from accountancy background because they would have taken accountancy seriously. Okay. So don't worry about that. Let's come back to the point, topic now, what we're going to study today. I'm not going to take much of your time today. Today, I know you people are very much confused, thinking about what is going to happen in the exam. We are going to shun all those, tensions from your mind. And we are going to focus upon our study, okay? I talked a lot about MCQs. Zakir is writing me. Hello, me. I'm waiting. Zakir, I'm not able to see your request. Okay. Okay, guys, let's start. So I talked a lot about MCQs and today we are going to do this MCQ practice sum of it. Okay. Okay. You people have to answer these questions. Can you people see the screen? The questions on your screen. Can you people see this? First, tell me. Yes, Manisha, Anayat, all of you can. That's good. Okay. So the question is moving along an indifference curve, consumer you know what happens? First is consumer prefers some of the consumption points to others. Marginal rate of substitution for a good increases as more of the good is consumed. Marginal rate of substitution is constant. And D, consumers do not prefer one consumption point to another. I'll give you some time. Read it and then tell me answer, okay? You have 2 minutes at the max. Okay, all of you try to answer, all of you. Rishi is writing B, Manisha is writing B, Salim is writing B, Riaz Malik is writing A, Avinash is writing B. So our house is divided on this thing. Some of them are saying A, some of them are writing B. Okay. Diksha is writing D, Sakshi is writing D, Anayat is writing D. Okay, we have people who think it is D. Good. Okay, time is up, guys. This is the time. I think I have given enough of the time to all of you. So if there is anybody who haven't answered, I'm waiting for him or her. You have to answer fast. Even if you don't know, write, do not know or answer. Try make, you know, any guess that you want to. Shivi has raised hand. Shivi, is there something that you want to ask me? What's my mistake? Okay. Guys, see. This is the question. Moving along an indifference curve. Okay, this is a question. Now, the first is, consumer prefers some of the consumption point to others. I mean, you see that this, if this is an indifference curve, you know, we started. If this is a point A, this is a point B. A or B may say, guys, tell me kaun sa preferable point hoga. Agar aap consumer hai, aap point A pe jayenge ya point B pe? Or tell me A. Okay, some of you are writing A, some of you are writing B. Okay, humne ye padha tha indifference curve mein. Mohan call, no, there is nothing like prices here. I think you skipped the chapter, don't worry. Sakshi is writing both, shayad. Sakshi, you are right. Hum na A point pe jayenge, na B point pe jayenge, dono ek jaise point hai. You know, एक indifference curve पे जो भी point होता है, they represent same level of the satisfaction. ये हमने पढ़ा था. Okay, don't worry. आप अभी पढ़ लीजिए. एक indifference curve पे जो भी point होते हैं, वो सारे same level of the satisfaction represent करते हैं. The first is wrong. Consumer will not prefer some points. कोई भी दूसरा point prefer नहीं करेगा. Second, marginal rate of substitution for a good increases as more of the good is consumed. ये अगर indifference curve है. MRS, marginal rate of substitution, जो उसकी slope है, जैसे जैसे हम along the indifference curve आते हैं, ये बोलते हैं कि ये increase करती है. क्या ये increase करती है? Yes or no? Tell me. क्या ये increase करती है marginal rate of substitution? Okay, no, no. Okay. Shiv is writing no. Mohan Kaul is writing yes. Okay, others tell me. All of you answer. I'm waiting for your answer. And try answer fast, okay? Because in this way we have to complete also. Okay, no problem. The answer is no, it does not. हमने प्रॉपर्टीज में पढ़ा था इन डिफरेंस कर्व की जो मार्जिनल रेट ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन होता है वो डिमिनिश करता है. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. ओके गाइज, नाउ वी लेफ्ट विद सी एंड डी. मार्जिनल रेट ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन इज कॉन्स्टेंट, मैंने आपको बताया डिमिनिश करता है तो ऑब्वियसली कॉन्स्टेंट भी नहीं होगा, ये भी गलत है. वी आर लेफ्ट विद डी. हम इसको पढ़े बिना भी बोल सकते हैं कि आंसर सही है क्योंकि वी आर लेफ्ट विद ओनली दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट. So the answer is D. अगर हम पढ़ें, consumers do not prefer one consumption point to another. Yes, we know because all the points on the indifference curve represents the same level of satisfaction. Got it? Is there any problem? Or shall we move to another question? Okay, good. अगला क्वेश्चन देखेंगे हम. मोहन, नाउ इज नॉट द टाइम कि मैं आपको ये लेक्चर फिर से करूं बिकॉज ये पूरा का पूरा लेक्चर है ये, जिसको हमने प्रोबेबली यू नो 3 से 4 लेक्चर्स में हमने ये किया है. सो वी डू नॉट गो कैन नॉट गो बैक. आप प्लीज रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर्स देख लीजिए, ठीक है? एंड देन इफ इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम टेल मी. आप सबने आंसर दे दिया है, स्लोप ऑफ इंडिफरेंस कर्व इज इक्वल टू मार्जिन रेट ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन. एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली. इसमें आई डोंट थिंक आई नीड टू रिपीट एनीथिंग. हम सब ने ये पढ़ लिया है और ऑल ऑफ यू हैव आंसर्ड. सो लेट्स मूव ऑन फर्दर. ओके, टेल मी व्हाई इज द इंडिफरेंस कर्व कन्वेक्स टू द ओरिजिन. वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन एंड आई वांट यू टू आंसर. इससे पता चलेगा आपने इंडिफरेंस कर्व कितनी अच्छी तरह से पढ़ा है. Diksha is giving A, Mohan is writing C, Shiv is writing C, Umang is writing D, Anayat A and B, Avinash B, Salim B. I'm very disappointed by your answers because you are not understanding question. Try to see question first. What it is asking you people. Why is indifference curve convex to the origin? Okay. Even if you don't know answers, आपको इतना तो पता होना चाहिए कि इनडिफरेंस कर्व हमने पढ़ा. ओके, तो इनडिफरेंस कर्व में हमने अभी तक किसके बारे में पढ़ा? क्या हमने डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिन यूटिलिटी के बारे में पढ़ा? राइट, यस और नो? राइट, यस और नो? फास्ट. दीक्षा इज सेइंग नो. गुड. साक्षी सेइंग नो. बाकी वाले? सलीम नो. नो नो. अविनाश? ओके गुड, हमने नहीं पढ़ा. मोहन कॉल आप बोल रहे थे सी मोनोटोनिक प्रेफरेंसेस. क्या हमने मोनोटोनिक प्रेफरेंसेस के बारे में पढ़ा इंडिफरेंस कर्व्स में? नो, दिस इज एन इंडिफरेंस कर्व बट हमने नहीं पढ़ा बिकॉज आई डिडंट फेल्ट कि ये आपके लिए रेलेवेंट है. यस नो है? गुड. ओके, जब ये दोनों नहीं रहा तो ए एंड बी, बी इज नॉट देयर, तो ये भी नहीं होगा ना. सिंपल है, आप हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड से भी ये क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर सकते हो. And you are left with A answer. फिर उसके बाद अगर हम आंसर में देखें, due to the continuous decline of marginal rate of substitution, yes, हमने पढ़ा MRS diminishing होता है, decline करता है. ये हमने पढ़ा, yes or no? Yes. आपको question पे time देना पड़ेगा. See question, then go on to the options. स्टूडेंट्स आई एम टेलिंग यू समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ओके लिसन नाउ. क्वेश्चन आना पड़ा होना या नहीं आना अलग चीज है, लेकिन क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करना इज एन आर्ट इन इटसेल्फ, वो आपको आनी चाहिए. आपके 50% क्वेश्चंस आपके एमसीक्यूज से निकल जाएंगे. अगर चार एमसीक्यूज हैं, लुक फॉर ट्राई टू मेक इट 1/4 की प्रोबेबिलिटी से ट्राई टू गेट इट 1-2. 50% प्रोबेबिलिटी पे लाने की कोशिश कीजिए. ट्राई एटलीस्ट 2 तो एलिमिनेट कर सको, उसके बाद गो फॉर. अगर नहीं आता है यू कैन हिट एंड ट्रायल, यू कैन गो, बट योर प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग द आंसर करेक्ट इज गेट्स यू नो हायर फ्रॉम 25 to 50%. यार ठीक है, सो लुक एट योर एमसी यू नो ऑप्शंस वेरी केयरफुली एंड ट्राई टू कोरिलेट कि क्या आपने पढ़ा है नहीं पढ़ा है. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके टेल मी दिस, रीड दिस नाउ. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस कर्व. Good Diksha, good Manisha, Anayat, good. Diksha is writing not conclave. Okay. C. Yes, Anayat, good. Okay. So you people know answer that indifference curve is concave to the origin. Okay. That's wonderful. Let's move further. Okay, tell me this. Diksha is writing B, good Diksha. Sakshi B, Anayat B, good Anayat. Good Avinash. Okay, so everybody knows the answer. Good Mohan. So, and higher indifference curve represents higher level of satisfaction. No problem in that. Let's move further. Okay. Tell me. Tell me, I'm waiting for your response. Advik is texting me that, sir, please allow me to be in. Advik, I'm not able to even see you, your request. Meanwhile, you people answer this thing, okay? Wait. I'll just... Okay. So let me see what you people have given answer. Anayat, you are saying C, I think. Diksha is saying D, Rishi is saying D, Shibi is saying D, Sakshi saying C. Okay, the question is, two indifference curves cannot intersect each other. We know this is the property of indifference curve. Why they do not represent, they cannot intersect each other. Okay, the reason being, the first is they represent those combination of two goods that give the same level satisfaction. That does not make sense, okay? So I would not go for this. This slope downwards, I mean, what it has got to do with the intersection? No. Each indifference curve represent a different level of satisfaction. Yes, it does. They are convex to the origin. Okay. So, it's a very interesting question. Salim is asking, sir, repeat disconnect due to net. Salim, there is nothing that I have said. I've just given you this question, okay? and you have to give answer to this. Try answer. Okay, you have already given answer. See. Yes, guys. The answer, I think, according to me, in this is each indifference curve represents a different level of satisfaction. And what we saw when we, you know, did this property, that if this is one IC1, this is IC2, you know, they cannot intersect because point A is lying on two indifference curves. But each indifference curve represents a different level of satisfaction. So A cannot be on two indifference curves. Okay, so answer is C. Got it? Are you people getting it? C is the answer. Yes. Okay. Good. So all of you answer C. That's correct. And all of you try to make the probability, increase your probability from 25 to 50%. Wonderful. That's the way you people answer. Okay. Now let's move further. So this is a question. Yeah. Tell me. An indifference curve slope downwards to the right, since more of one commodity and less of another result in what? Again, a good question. Anayat is writing D. Sakshi is writing D. Shiv is writing D. Manisha is writing D. Salim is writing D. We are waiting for Vikas' answer also. Salim is writing D. Okay, so all of you are writing D. And answer to this question is, let me see. Mohan Kaul is writing A. Mohan, you know, it is, I'll tell you something. You know, you do not have to see what is different and what is, you know, at times what people have this habit of, I'll tell you, most of the students, they commit this mistake that if there are 3-4 options given and it is written A, B, C and 1. Okay. And the question is, which among the following, which among the following is an alphabet, or yes, which among the following is an alphabet is a question, and the options may be given as A, B, or A, B, C, or D. Okay, so what people try and do, you know, they see, okay, these three are same, and this one is, you know, looking somewhat different. So let's try to answer this. That's wrong. That's very wrong approach. Okay. That's wrong. You have to minimize your, you know, you have to maximize your probability of getting right and minimize your probability of getting wrong. But that does not mean that go for something that is looking different in the options. If you do not know, then your probability remains zero. Okay. But if you know, if you have studied the topic, then only you can make guesses. Got it? Let's move further. Okay, I think we're done with the MCQs. Let me, yeah. We have MCQ here. Just a sec. Okay. Try to answer this question. Salim, I think we gave answer of the previous question. Isn't that so? Yes. All of your writing C, yes, the slope of the indifference curve tends to decline. And what is the slope of indifference curve? Marginal rate of substitution. It tends to decline. Okay. So it is not here, it is not here, it is this C is out. Let's move further. Try to answer this. Allen and Hicks or Hicks and Allen believe that utility Umang is writing that it is B, Diksha is writing B, Sakshi is writing B, Anait is writing B. Avinash is writing A. Okay. Let me get back to the question. Okay, tell me, what Allen and Hicks gave? They gave indifference curve. Okay. And what indifference curve they depend upon? Cardinal utility or ordinal utility? Tell me, it's A, that's B. A or B? Manisha is saying ordinal. Others? Mohan call, okay, ordinal. Sakshi is saying ordinal. Okay, if all of you people know ordinal, then how can it be A answer or C answer or D answer? It has to be B, guys. Okay, is that clear? Yes. Do we have any other question? Let me see. I think we're done with the question. No problem. We did this. Yes. This as well. I think this as well, and this as well. Yes, we did this question. Yes, we did this question as well. We're done with this as well. Yes. Okay, we're done with the question, guys. Okay. I had this bunch of questions for you people. So that we could discuss what we did. And I feel this topic is very important for all of you. Mohan is asking me still one answer, two questions. What, Mohan, you're trying to ask me? Mohan, what one answer and two questions? Okay, Avinash, got it. Don't worry. One. Yes, Anand, objective plays an important part. You don't have to thank me. Okay. Thank yourself. Prepare hard. Okay. I'll ask you a few questions, then we'll conclude. Today, I'm not going to take much of your time. Okay. I'll just. Yeah. Okay. So this is your space now. Okay. at this box. Yeah. Now my question is, what is the slope of budget line? Okay. This is A, guys. This is B. This is C. This is D. Tell me. And that's your question. Umang is writing A. Sakshi is writing A. Avinash, you're writing straight line is not the budget, is not the slope of the budget line, okay? Avinash, what is asked to you is, can you even see a straight line in the options? I know it is a straight line, but it is not the slope. Yes, okay. Diksha A. Good, all of you. So, Avinash, in order to know, you have to study. In order to study, you have to look for the lectures. Okay? Don't worry. So, this is the answer. A. That is price of X upon price of Y. That is the slope of the budget line. Got it? Okay. Let's move further. That's again your box. The question is, at point of equilibrium of indifference curve, okay, A option, slope of, that is budget line, is greater than slope of indifference curve. The slope of budget line is less than slope of indifference curve. C, slope of budget line is equal to slope of indifference curve. Or D, okay, none of the above. All of you try to answer. Good, good. Yes, slope of the budget line is equal to slope of indifference curve. How it is? If this is the indifference curve, this is the budget line. At this point, okay, what happens? Slope of the budget line. What is the slope of the budget line? We did. Price of X upon price of Y is equal to slope of the indifference curve. And what is the slope of indifference curve? We know it is a marginal rate of substitution of X for Y. And they both are equal to what? Marginal utility of X upon marginal utility of Y. So, is that clear? Yes, sab humne pehle padha hua. Let's move further. Again, this is your box. My question is, can indifference curve, this is can, okay? Can indifference curve be straight lines such as this? Can this be the shape of indifference curve? ऑप्शन ए इज यस, ऑप्शन बी इज नो. टेल मी. नो 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 नो. ओके, सो व्हाई आई ऑलवेज टेल यू पीपल टू प्रैक्टिस यू नो एमसीक्यूज इज, नाउ आई टेल यू, जितना हमने अभी तक पढ़ा है यू पीपल आर करेक्ट, यस इट कैन नॉट बी, बट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू स्टडी एन इम्पॉर्टेंट यू नो कंक्लूजन इन दिस चैप्टर. उसको आप दिमाग में रखें. देखिए, दो इंपॉर्टेंट शेप्स हैं जो आपको याद रखनी. ये एक इंडिफरेंस कर्व, यस ये शेप होती है, आंसर इज यस. ओके, दूसरा एक शेप ये वाली शेप, एल शेप, ये एल शेप, ओके ये भी होती है. दीज आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट शेप्स जो आपको याद रखनी है. ओके, हम एमसीक्यूज इसीलिए सॉल्व करते हैं, हमें वो चीजें पता चलती हैं जो हमने नहीं पढ़ी. अगर ये शेप है इंडिफरेंस कर्व की, ये होता है परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट. परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट का मतलब, फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम क्रिकेट खेलते हैं, फॉरगेट क्रिकेट, मैं पेन से लिख रहा हूं तो मेरे पास रोटोमैक का पेन है या मेरे पास यू नो कोई कंपनी यू नो लेट्स से पार्कर का पेन है. इफ आई एम नॉट ब्रांड ऑब्सेस्ड पर्सन, तो मुझे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता या तो मेरे पास रोटोमैक का है या पार्कर का है, मुझे सिर्फ लिखने से मतलब. तो ऐसे ये गुड्स जो एक दूसरे को हम सब्स्टिट्यूट कर सकते हैं बिना किसी प्रॉब्लम के, उनको बोलते हैं परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट. और एग्जांपल दूं अगर, ठीक है, अगर मैं आपसे बोलूं यू नो आप लोग चाय पीते हैं, हम एग्जांपल लेंगे यहाँ पर ऋषि की. ऋषि चाय को, चाय बहुत पसंद है. मैं उसको ताज़ा की चाय दूं या लिप्टन की चाय दूं, अगर चाय अच्छी है तो उसे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता कि कौन सा ब्रांड है. सो दीज टू गुड्स आर परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर ईच अदर, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, सो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगी. ऐसे गुड्स का इंडिफरेंस कर्व अगर हम बनाए तो इस तरह से बनता. ओके, दूसरा आता है कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स का. सलीम, ये टच नहीं करेगा एक्सिस को, क्या हमने प्रॉपर्टीज नहीं पढ़ी? अगर ये टच करता है एक्सिस को, दैट मींस हमारी प्रेफरेंसेस क्या होंगी? मोनोटोनिक. मोनोटोनिक का मतलब, फॉरगेट दिस लाइन, आपको मतलब समझाता हूं. अगर यहां पर है, दैट मींस वी आर कंज्यूमिंग ओनली वन कमोडिटी, दैट इज दिस कमोडिटी, वी आर नॉट कंज्यूमिंग दिस कमोडिटी. एंड ये हमारी अजम्पशन है कि हम जो पैसा इनकम है वो दो कमोडिटी पे खर्चते हैं. तो ये इंडिफरेंस कर्व हमने पहले से पढ़ा था. प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इंडिफरेंस कर्व इज दैट इट डज नॉट टच एनी ऑफ द एक्सिस, किसी भी एक्सिस को ये टच नहीं करता. गॉट इट सलीम? ओके, कमिंग बैक, कॉम्प्लीमेंट और कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स. कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स क्या होते हैं? फॉर एग्जाम्पल टी एंड कॉफी. अब समवन लाइक मी हु प्रेफर्स कॉफी, ओके, वो चाय नहीं पिएगा. इंडिफरेंस कर्व इज नॉट नेगेटिव एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस मोन कॉल? ये समझ नहीं आ रहा. ओके, सुनिए, टी एंड कॉफी. ओके, यस सलीम, आप जो पूछ रहे हो इट इज नॉट कन्वेक्स. यस इट इज नॉट कन्वेक्स. ये मैं आपको स्पेशल केसेस बता रहा हूं दो. ओके, दीज आर नॉट जनरल केसेस, तभी हमने नहीं पढ़े. परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट्स और कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स के दो आपको एक ऐसे मैं यू नो केसेस बता रहा हूं जिस केस में इंडिफरेंस कर्व कैसे होंगे. ओके, यू कैन नॉट गो एंड से कि हमने इस तरह से पढ़ा है. एग्जाम में आपको ऐसा आ सकता है कि ये शेप इंडिफरेंस कर्व की किसकी होती है, ये शेप परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट की होती है, और ये वाली शेप एल शेप किस तरह से किसकी होती है, ये कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स की होती है. गॉट इट? आपको ही पता होना चाहिए. कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स कौन से होते हैं? मैंने बताया टी एंड कॉफी। इफ यू प्रेफर कॉफी तो आप टी पी लोगे, बट दैट वोंट बी द परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट, और शायद आप ना भी लो। यस, परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट एंड कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स। ओके, ये हमने पहले से पढ़ा है कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स क्या होते हैं, परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट्स क्या होते हैं। सो नाउ यू नो द इंडिफरेंस कर्व दोनों के। ओके, तो दिस ये किसका है, परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट्स या कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स? टेल मी। थैंक यू सलीम, डोंट डोंट वरी, टेल मी द आंसर। ए और बी, दिस इंडिफरेंस कर्व रिप्रेजेंट्स द इंडिफरेंस कर्व्स ऑफ विच, ए और बी, परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट और कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स? ए। यस। सिमिलरली दिस रिप्रेजेंट्स व्हाट, ए और बी? ऑप्शंस आर सेम, ए एंड बी। बी, गुड। ओके, गुड। सो वी हैव डन दिस एज वेल। व्हाट एल्स वी वर लेफ्ट? आई डोंट थिंक दैट वी आर लेफ्ट विद एनीथिंग इन इन डिफरेंस कर्व्स। इवन इफ एंड देन आल्सो इफ यू हैव एनी ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम यू कैन आस्क मी। ओके, एंड वी विल डू सम अदर एमसीक्यूज आल्सो इन द कमिंग लेक्चर्स। आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल फॉर द डे। ओके, सो आई मीन वर्क हार्ड, घर जाओ पढ़ो अच्छी तरह से, और बाकी सब्जेक्ट्स को भी देखो। डू नॉट फोकस यू नो सिर्फ अकाउंटेंसी पे। आई नो आप सबको उसकी टेंशन है, एंड अभी एक महीना है, डोंट वरी। एक अपना सिलेबस बनाओ, सॉरी अपना एक टाइम टेबल बनाओ, उस पे यू नो कंप्लाई करो, एंड यू विल बी थ्रू। माय बेस्ट विशेस विद ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू विल क्रैक दिस एग्जाम। ओके, सो बेस्ट ऑफ लक, बाय बाय, टेक केयर। दीक्षा पीडीएफ अपलोड नहीं हुई, दीक्षा आज हो जाएगी, डोंट वरी। ओके, और आप सबको, या थैंक यू अविनाश, बेस्ट ऑफ लक टू ऑल ऑफ यू, बाय, टेक केयर।